Welcome to tonight's contest. Here are your Rochester High School varsity player.
I'm Luke Kennedy, number 40, and I'm a forward.
Alec Garrick, senior, number 24, forward.
I'm Brandon Camp, I'm a senior, and I'm a shooting guard.
I'm Carter Screen, I'm a senior, and I play point guard.
Brett Abbott, shooting guard, sophomore.
I'm Alec Holland, I'm a sophomore and a guard.
Matthew Bastrom, senior, forward.
Dom Thomas, I'm a junior, and power forward.
Noah Dahlquist, junior, center.
I'm Taylor Medina, I'm a junior and a forward.
What I'd like to see was he hitting that 8 to 10 foot jumper on a consistent basis.
You know, Southwood put up a good fight. I mean, there were no easy buckets in that ball game for the JV, and so Dahlquist did a good job. He knocked down some 7-8 footers. I thought Dom Thomas knocked down a couple 7-8 footers as well, and I thought some of the other kids out front did a good job of handling the basketball under a lot of pressure. You know, the hot Jackson Sawyer, he's only 5'6". And a freshman, but I thought he handled the ball pretty well out front under some pretty hard pressure from Southwood.
Yeah, I agree. So Rochester wins the tip. We got a loose ball on the floor, and Harmon grabs the basketball, but not before he goes out of bounds, so we'll stay with Rochester baseline right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 11 seconds into the game, Rochester has that out of bounds, baseline right, as Medina looks to trigger it in. No look past the Holland, the Garrick on the right wing inside the arc, and we're going to have a foul coming in on the reach in from behind on Zach Hobson. You know, I was watching these Southwood Knights shoot in the pregame on fire. They were lights out.
Yeah, let's hope they burn up their good ones in pregame.
Right in front of the Southwood bench, Holland looks to get it in over the top of the defense to Kennedy. Luke, underhand pass back to Holland, who brings it top of the key in that 2-3 zone, extended out to the volleyball line. And the pass is tipped away, but right into the hands of Garrick. Alec Garrick, a couple of the dribbles down the screen, high on the right side. Screen in the middle of the floor, high on the left side, down the Garrick, on the baseline to Kennedy. Luke, a couple of the dribbles, right wing pass to Screen, right corner to Holland, three on the way, blocked out of bounds.
Well, what we saw from the JV from Southwood, I think, is carried over and, you know, going to be a telltale for the varsity as well. No easy shots.
That's exactly what, anytime John Burris has a team, he's got that 2-3 zone working as Holland pulls up from 18 feet, draws nothing but air, and Phillippe the rebound. And then Ross Phillippe leads, makes that Corey Phillippe, leads Ross Phillippe just a little bit too far and out of bounds. But let me finish that. Anytime that John Burris gets a team on the floor, it's always going to be pressure. Even though it says 2-3 zone, it's always in your face.
You're right, and they're going to be prepared. You're not going to catch him by surprise.
Full court press by Southwood. Garrick has it from Kennedy. Garrick bounce pass ahead to Screeton. Rochester's going to have to hurry and get that across the timeline. Kennedy does through the center circle at the volleyball or at the free throw line, pulls up and drains it.
Well, Luke Kennedy's got the ability to drain that shot from 10 feet. Anybody else, you'd have told him to take it all the way to the basket.
Yeah, and he's got it, really.
Yeah.
Ross Phillippe, leaner on the baseline, no good. Ball tipped around. Kennedy comes out of there with him for Rochester. And now to Screeton. Screeton jogs it up the floor. 2-3 zone, picks him up at the timeline. Spits the defense to Kennedy. Luke, just inside the three-point line, down low to Canada, or makes that to Medina. Medina's pass is knocked away, but Holland there to pick it up. Splits the defense out to Kennedy, three on the way, right wing. Nope, too hard off the back of the rim. Ball fought for. Ball still loose on the floor. There's a scramble for it. Screen comes out of there with it, and then throws it right into the hands of Jackson Blair. Blair in the middle of the floor, jump pass, or make that jump stop. And we're going to have a foul on the floor. It'll be out of bounds to Southwood with 6:22 to play in the first quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
The foul comes against Screeton, his first, team first.
2-0 Rochester. Corey Phillippe gets it into Blair in the left corner. Blair on the wing now, one dribble, jump pass to Harmon down low, his layup on the way. And before the shot, we're going to have another foul in Rochester. Be out of bounds again to the Southwood Knights.
I think they're going to get Holland reaching in from underneath.
6:17 to play in the first, 2-0 Rochester.
Wasn't much Holland could do except grab the elbow. He gives up about a foot.
Ross Phillippe on the left wing works against Kennedy. Rochester in a man-to-man defense to Corey on the block. Corey Phillippe backs his way in, throws up a shot, and on the shot, Carter Screeton just picked up foul number two, and that's going to send Corey Phillippe, the 6'1 senior, to the line to shoot two.
Three fouls on the Zebras in less than 30 seconds.
Yeah.
About
two guards, by the way.
Yeah.
So going to the free throw line is Corey Phillippe for the Southwood Knights. As he eyes the first one, lets it fly, and it's good as it rattles in. He'll have one more. Southwood on the board. With virtually 2 minutes gone here in the opening quarter here at Southwood High School, the Zebras up 2-1. One more free throw coming from Corey Phillippe. Phillippe eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's good again, and we're tied at two. Full court press by Southwood. Kennedy gets it in quickly to Holland. Holland stands in the corner. Now it's the free throw line of Southwood. Picks up his dribble, and his pass is stolen away by Corey Phillippe. Corey Phillippe, right side, backs his way in. His pass is knocked away by Garrick, and then Garrick is fouled to reach in by Hobson. And I believe that's going to be Hobson's second.
Yeah, it is.
Probably Coach Burris is going to go to the bench, but well, I think anyway.
That's one of the risks you take with that full court pressure, that you start picking up cheap little fouls.
So Gary gets the basketball inbound screen. He loses it from behind.
Hops about got third.
Blair picks it up, pulls up from the free throw line. He drains it. Jackson Blair has his first three of the game for Southwood. It's 4-2. Nice. Full court press again for Southwood. Screen pushes ahead to Garrick. Garrick through the double team, across the sideline, down the elbow, pulls up. Gives it back outside to Screen, fakes a three. Now out of Holland in the left corner. He'll fire it from the baseline. It's good. Rochester up now 5-4 with 5:20 to play in the first quarter. Ross Phillippe quickly up the floor, left side of the floor. Southwood going to our left. Phillippe loses the ball in the lane, and we're going to have a foul on the reach in. And just so if you're listening to the basketball game tonight as you were last night, this cat that just whistled a foul against Rochester is the same cat that teed up Coach Stasiak last night.
You're not trying to say anything about that.
No, I'm not implying anything.
No implications.
Absolutely not.
Okay, I just want to be clear.
Brandon Camp in the game for the first time for Rochester as Screeton comes out with two personal fouls. Ross Phillippe works to the left wing, switches directions to the free throw line now. Out to Blair. Blair penetrates, kicks it outside to Corey Phillippe. Three, left wing. Good. Southwood back up now 7-5. 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Rochester breaks the press. Kennedy will fire a three. It's short. He gets his own rebound. He goes to the basket hard. His shot's blocked. Corey Phillippe picks up the ball and runs. Phillippe picks his way through traffic. Right wing now for Southwood. Left corner pass now. Now gives it down low to wide open Harmon. He's done. Rises up and flushes it with two hands.
You wouldn't think it'd be easy to lose somebody at 6'5". He found himself all alone down low on the paint. They got it to him.
Kennedy near the timeline against the double team. Got to get rid of it. Over the top of the defense to Cam. Cam to the corner to Medina. Right wing to Kennedy. Outside to Holland on the right baseline. He dribbles to the wing. Wrap around pass to Garrick. Garrick in the paint. Pass down low to Kennedy. He'll take the 10-foot on the baseline. No good. Harmon to the rebound. Harmon gives to Ross Phillippe. Southwood runs up by four. Southwood going to our left to Corey Phillippe. Three on the way, right side, way off the mark, no good. Harmon to the rebound. The putback is good. Timeout, Rochester. It's a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
3:58 to play in the first quarter. Southwood now out to an 11-5 lead, and Coach Reinholt burns a timeout. And the Zebras will have it going to the length of the floor. Down by six, under four to play in the first quarter.
I tell you what, Jake Harmon, the 6'5 sophomore, playing like a senior to start this ball game. A couple of block shots, definitely a presence in the paint.
Full court press by Southwood. And the stolen by Ross Phillippe. He puts up the baby hook jump in the lane. It's good. 13-5 is an 8-point lead now for Southwood. The inbounds pass comes into Camp. Full court press by Southwood. Kennedy skies for the basketball, gets the pass, gives immediate into cutting Holland. And Holland wide open under the bucket, and it goes off his hands and out of bounds.
Well, that's the fifth turnover now for Rochester here in the first quarter.
Wow, that was an easy two, and yep. Holly just didn't look it in. Here comes a half-court trap by the Zebras. Ross Phillippe crosses the timeline high on the right side. Jump pass down little Harmon, and it tips off his fingertips and out of bounds. 3.5 to play first quarter. Southwood by 8. It's 13-5. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Zebras of the basketball going to our right.
Well, I get the impression this Southwood team's deceptively quick as well. They don't look quick out here on the floor, but, boy, they always seem to be a step ahead.
Yeah, you're right. Medina, 18-footer over Harmon, is off the back of the rim. No good. And Blair with a rebound. Southwood runs. Blair, left side of the floor, gives offside to Kirk. Noah Kirk with the basketball. Now to Blair, runs the baseline. Skip pass is kicked out of bounds by Garrick. It'll stay with Southland underneath their own basket. And back into the game is Carter Screeton and Camp coming out. 3:11 to play in the first quarter. Southwood up 13-5. It'll be their basketball baseline right as Corey Phillippe looks to trigger it in. Bounce pass into Ross Phillippe. Yes, Twins. High on the right side against the double team. Over the top of the defense to Blair. Jackson Blair. Jump pass to Corey Phillippe in the left wing. Corey Phillippe now top to Ross Phillippe. Back to Corey Phillippe. Looks at a three, passes it up. Now to Ross, top of the key. Ross Phillippe, jump pass to Corey Phillippe. I tell you what, I think he's got that green light to shoot that any time.
Right.
And then Corey loses the basketball to Kirk, but out to Ross Phillippe.
What Coach Burris say, he had 34 the other night. I think that gives anybody a green light.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
And that pass goes down low to Blair and right through his hands out of bounds. And Brett Abbott will come in for the first time for the Rochester Zebras. And Abbott will replace Taylor Medina with 2:43 to play in the first quarter. 13-5 Southwood. Nice in a full-court press. Gary gets the inbounds pass from Holland. Wrap around pass to Kennedy. Kennedy, left side of the floor, pulls up from 15 feet. It is short, and the rebound to Corey Phillippe, and he runs. Corey Phillippe, right side of the floor. Misses Harmon, wide open under the basket. Out to Ross Phillippe. Backs it in, kicks it out to Corey Phillippe. Three off the back of the iron, no good. Garrick with the rebound. Garrick against the Southwood off the miss, sets up the press. Kennedy, baseline to Abbott, back to Kennedy. Luke in the corner to Holland. Holland fakes a three, pulls up, jumper from 15 feet is no good. Ball being tipped around, and Kirk comes out of there for Southwood. He gives off to Blair. Jackson Blair, left side of the floor, gives him the baseline to Harmon. Harmon travels, no call. Spinner on the way. There's the call.
Yep.
So the ball going to go back to Rochester, and Coach Burris will go to the bench, and he'll send in Luke Elliott and also send in Paris, Logan Paris, with 2 minutes to play in the first quarter.
Well, with Harmon sitting down, Rochester is going to gain a height advantage, but at the same time, they're going to take Kennedy out and give him a breather.
I think that's a good idea. Medina back in. Rochester looking at a full-court press. Holland looks to get it in, does so to Garrick in the corner. Alec Garrett, a couple of dribbles up the floor, gets it ahead to Medina across the timeline. Medina right side of the floor, jump pass left wing to Screeton. Screeton holds, drives it inside the three-point line out to Holland. Alec Holland back to Screeton left wing. Screeton holds, flashing to the middle of Medina, back outside to Holland, fakes the three, gives to Garrett. He drives the baseline. He's going to be fouled on the way to the rack by Elliott. And it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester with a minute 42 to play in the first quarter.
Number 20, Luke Elliott, first team third.
Elliott's first team third.
And Medina will look to get it in baseline right with 1:42 to play in the first quarter, down by eight. Medina to Garrick. Leaner off the window. No good. Partially blocked. Elliott with the rebound. Now gives to Blair. Jackson Blair for Southwood. Left side of the floor. Pulls up. Resets for Southwood. Now drives inside the arc. 18-footers off the market. No good. And Garrick with the rebound. And he runs. Rochester the basketball going to our right. Garrick gives to Medina on the baseline. Medina skip pass to Abbott. Abbott loses the handle. Picks it up. Now to Holland. Pat, top of the three key. Good!
Second three this quarter for Holland.
I should say top of the key three. And it's 13-8, a minute 10 to play in the first quarter. Ross Phillippe wrap around pass to Elliott. His shot's blocked out of bounds by Garrick. Get it out of here!
Good timing by Alec Garrick.
Kennedy back into the game. Harmon coming back into the game. Ross Phillippe to sit for Southwood, and Garrick will sit for Rochester. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. A minute 7 to play in the first quarter. Southwood up 13-8. 3-4. Southwood is no good. And Garrick make that screen to the rebound, and he is fouled by Paris near the timeline. It'll be Rochester basketball to bounds. 13-8 Southwood. A minute to play the first quarter. Rochester the basketball going to our right. Straighten will look to get it in. Does so at the free throw line of Southwood to Holland. Holland against the double team ahead to Screeton. Carter crosses the timeline against Paris. Now Southwood falls back in at 2-3 zone, extended to the timeline. Kennedy in the paint. Kicks it out to Medina. Now to Screeton high on the right side with 45. Left side to Holland with 42. Alec Holland backs it out and resets for Rochester with 39. His pass is stolen by Phillippe. Corey Phillippe, right side of the floor, hesitates, accelerates, goes to the baseline, cut off by the defense, down low to Harmon. Harmon in the paint, jumper short, rebound to Elliott. The putback is good. 15-8, Southwood, 22 seconds to play, first quarter. Holland across the timeline to Screeton. Down low, ball tipped away, still loose. Abbott picks it up with 14. Abbott kicks it out to Holland with 12. Alec Holland gives to Screeton with 9. Screeton drives it right with 6. Picks up his dribble to Medina with 5. Now to Holland with 3. His 3 on the way from the baseline is no good. Torrey Philby is a rebound. And at the buzzer, Holland picks up foul number 2. So after 1, Southwood leads 15-8. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Here we go to the second quarter right now at Southwood High School. The Knights leading the Rochester Zebras 15-8. And the Knights will start with the basketball. Boy, 2-3 zone means different things to different people. But the Southwood 2-3 zone is smothering.
Starts at midcourt. And, yeah, you're right. It starts with a half-court trap, and you're lucky if you can get it to the three-point line. And Rochester's been content to take some shots that they probably shouldn't
have.
Yeah,
you're right.
Just because they're, you know, about all they can do to get it up to that point.
Hobson back into the game for Southwood with 2 fouls. Harmon has it in the corner. Over the top of the defense to Blair. Quickly right side to Corey Phillippe. He'll pull up from 15 foot on the baseline. It's short. Harmon has it on the baseline. The offensive rebound. The putback no good. Ball being tipped around and out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by the Zebras. It'll stay with Southwood. Active, very active on the board.
They're getting a lot, you know, Southwood's getting some good scoring balance.
3 on the way for Hobson, short. Kennedy with the rebound for the Zebras. And Luke gives off to Streeton. 30 seconds gone in the second quarter. Kennedy with the basketball in the paint, kicks it out to Garrick. Garrick out to now Streeton. Streeton at the free throw line to Medina, and he travels and got away with it. Down low to Kennedy. Kennedy on the block, still in trouble against a double team. Now to Medina high on the right side. Streeton holds in the middle of the floor near the center circle. Jump pass to Garrick on the right wing.
And there's just no breather because the ball is double-teamed almost every time.
That shot by Kennedy at the free throw line is no good. Southwood with the rebound. Hobson runs. Hobson left side of the floor against Rochester's double team. Out to Jackson Blair, who gives him the corner to Corey Phillippe. No look pass down low to Harmon. Spinner on the baseline is no good. Rebound fall for Abbott has it. Streeton pushes ahead to Medina. Medina goes to the basket hard, and his shot is blocked by Harmon, picked up by Hobson. Hobson runs it through the center circle, now high on the right side to Blair. Jump pass to Corey Phillippe on the right wing. Phillippe back to Blair. He'll fire a long three for the Knights. It's good. 18-8 Southwood, 6:25 to play in the first half. Garrick to Medina. Rochester needs to cross the timeline, and Medina passes to Garrick and does so. Jump pass to Abbott. Abbott runs the baseline against the triple team out to Garrick. Now to Screeton. Screeton, one dribble inside the three-point line. Got to give it up. Does so to Garrick on the left side. He dribbles to the top of the key. Southwood still in that 2-3 zone. Garrick dribbles. Now Bass pass to Screeton left side at the elbow. Now right side to Medina. Down low to Kennedy. 15-footer right baseline. Good. Rochester cuts it inside double digits. It's 18-10 with 5:50 to play in the first half. Jump pass ahead to Corey Phillippe. Drives the baseline against Kennedy. Runs over Kennedy. No call. Leaner off the glass is no good. And the rebound to Garrick. And now we're going to have a foul, I believe, on Harmon for coming over the back.
That is indeed on
Harmon, his first. I really thought Corey Phillippe Kennedy drew a charge on Corey Phillippe, but apparently the official down low thought it was a flop.
Yeah, I don't know. I kind of thought there was some contact there as well.
So Rochester makes a substitution.
And I don't see a no-call circle, so.
Not yet. That's next.
Not yet, right.
Holland, Garrick, Southwood of the full court press. Over the top of the defense to Kennedy. Kennedy stops, pops, high off the glass. Nope. Rebound fought for Medina's putback is good. That's nice. An athletic move,
yeah.
Right there by Medina.
Nice job by Medina. He knew that he was in a crowd and he wasn't going to have time to bring that ball down on the rebound, so he just kept it up on the glass and tapped it in.
18-12. Southwood on top. Blair gives to Kirk, dumps down low to Harmon on the block. Harmon goes to the basket, pull-up jumper, blocked.
Wow.
By Garrick at the second block of the game. That could have been very easily
another,
a goaltending,
yeah,
I thought.
Another nice time to jump by Garrick.
Holland loses the basketball out of bounds. They're going to say last touch, though, by Southwood. It'll stay with the Zebras baseline right.
Holland had a step on Kennedy and had Kennedy on his hip, and Garrick come from the opposite side of the lane and timed it perfectly and caught that ball just before it crossed the barrier of the rim. So we're saying.
That's how I saw it. Medina in the lane, kicks it out to Garrick, quickly to Holland right side at the free throw line, discreet, and he'll fire a three left wing. Good! And all of a sudden, the Zebras have cut this 10-point lead to three.
Well, that's how you break a zone. Start knocking down the three.
That's right. Blair, he's not shy. He'll pull up from 15 feet. No good. And now we're going to have a... They're going to say last touch by Luke Kennedy. Harmon came over the back of Kennedy, and Luke knocked it out of bounds. It'll stay with Southwood baseline right. Ross Phillippe back into the game, and coming out for Southwood is Hobson. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 4:38 to play in the first half. Southwood by three. Corey Phillippe gives to Ross Phillippe left side. Corner to Kirk. He'll fire a three. It's off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Basham, who's in the game for the first time, who gives to Streeton. Rochester runs down by three. It was once 18-8. Now 18-15. Holland feeds down low. Pass kicked away by Blair, and it'll stay with Rochester baseline left with 4:18 to play in the first half.
Coach Burris mentioned that he was impressed by Rochester's ability to hold Northfield scoreless in the second quarter, and so far they've managed to hold Southwood to 3 points.
4:17 to play in the second quarter. Southwood up 18-15. And it'll be Rochester basketball to bounce baseline left. Screen gets it in at the Southwood volleyball line as Garrick will bring it up and across it right through the center circle and get it high on the left side to Holland. Holland in the corner to Basham. Down low to Medina. Medina, jumper is on the way. No good, but a foul coming on Southwood. I think that Medina has gotten away with three or four travels in this quarter.
Yeah.
So Medina will go to the line to shoot two.
That foul coming against Blair. His first team six.
Medina with two freebies here with an opportunity to cut this lead to one. Taylor ready. Eyes the first one. Lets it fly. It's no good.
Well, I was about to say that Medina's doing something that none of the other Zebras have been able to find, and that's an open seam and an open lane to the basket. But
yeah.
You may have explained why that's the case.
Second one by Medina is good this time. 18-16 Southwood, and Ross Phillippe will bring it up the floor. And Medina picks him up at his own volleyball line. Ross Phillippe crosses the timeline to Corey Phillippe. Jump pass to Harmon. Harmon drives the baseline, throws up a shot. It's good, and a foul. And is that going to be on Holland? If it is, that's number three on Alec.
Nope. They're going to catch Garrick, give him his second. Team six.
Zebras have a plethora of two fouls.
Yeah, Holland, Streeton, and Garrick all with two.
3:55 to play in the first half. And Alex Harmon at the line to shoot one. Free throw is too hard, but an offensive rebound by Corey Phillippe puts it back in good. Somebody fell asleep.
Yep.
And now it's back to a 6-point lead for Southwood.
Plays like that will get you 34 points in a game.
Yeah. And now Bash has passed the tape away by Blair. Gives to Ross Phillippe. Coach Burris says run. Ross Phillippe left side of the floor. Now Medina rides the hip of Ross Phillippe up the floor and is whistled for a foul. That's going to send Ross Phillippe to the line to shoot one and the bonus.
Medina picks up his first.
And Coach Reinhold going back to the bench, and Camp and Kennedy will come back in. And Basham and Garrick to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We're at Southwood High School, where the Knights own a six-point lead, and Ross Phillippe at the line to shoot one in the bonus with 3.5 minutes to play in the first half. Phillippe's first one, good. We'll have one more. Ross Phillippe with one more freebie for the Southwood Knights, looking to push this lead to 8. Phillippe eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's no good. Kennedy skies to the board and gives to Holland. Holland almost loses. Now we're going to have a reach and foul on Noah Kirk. Wow.
He about had possession of that basketball when they called the foul.
I agree. That was a touchy foul there.
That's his first.
So Holland at the line to shoot one and the bonus for the Zebras. Down by 7. Again, with 3.5 to play in the first half. Alec Holland ties the first one, lets it fly, and it's good.
That's 7 for Holland tonight.
2 fouls.
3. Yeah, you're right, 2.
Holland ties it, flies it, good again. 23-18 Southwood. And the ball tipped out of bounds by Medina. It'll stay at the center timeline, I should say, right in front of the scorer's table, and Blair will look to get it in. Ross Phillippe will bring it across the timeline, right through the center circle to Blair. Blair jump pass to a wide-open Corey Phillippe, 3 on the way for Southwood, way off the mark.
Way hard.
And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Harmon, and Zebra's going to get it back.
He would have had to stand in the third row of the bleachers for that to be close.
Full-court press of the night. Medina gets it in, quickly ahead, is the pass tipped away by Corey Phillippe. And Rochester keeping on the far side. 3:17 to play in the second quarter. 23-18 Southwood. Medina looks to get it in. Does so to a wide-open Kennedy. Kennedy drives. Fakes the shot. Kicks it out to Camp. Camp right side to Holland. Right wing. At the elbow now to Medina. He drives it right. Gives to Abbott, who drives the baseline. Leaner off the glass. No good. Harmon to the rebound. It gives to Blair. Jackson Blair for Southwood through the center circle. Jump pass down low to Kirk. Kirk to a cutting Harmon. Harmon loses the basketball, but a foul coming on Rochester, and that's going to send Alex Harmon back to the line to shoot one of the bonus for the night.
So they're going to get Medina on the foul. That'll be his second, team 8.
Hobson back into the game for Southwood, and Kirk to sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 2:57 to play. In the first half, Southwood up 23-18 as Alec Garrick back into the game. And Camp to sit. Harmon, one of the bonus for his Knights. First one on the way. Short. And ball fought for. Kennedy comes out of there with it. Now to Garrick. Alec passes ahead to Medina, who gives to Kennedy. Rochester with the numbers. No look pass to Abbott in the paint. Gives it out to Kennedy. Kennedy at the free throw line. Now to Garrick. Garrick runs the point. Now just called for the double dribble. And now the Knights want a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball. I beg your pardon. It's going to be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Two and a half minutes to play in the first half. out of the with the basketball and a 23-18 lead. As Harmon gets the dump pass inside, kicks it outside to Ross Phillippe. Ross to Blair, right wing, back to Ross Phillippe on the left wing. And his pass is tipped away and stolen by Abbott, gives to Medina. Medina, no look pass to Garrick. Right-handed layup is good. A foul!
Nice job by Garrick. He kept his spacing coming down the floor and was able to get a good angle and absorb that contact.
So Garrick goes to the line to shoot one free throw, looking to cut this lead to two with 2:11 to play in the first half. Garrick eyes it, flies it, short. Corey Phillippe with the rebound. Now gives off to Ross Phillippe. Half-court trap by the Zebras. Ball loose, picked up by Ross Phillippe.
Zebras gets play a little of their own aggressive 2-3
zone. Yeah, you're right. Hobson around the defense, pulls up from 5 foot, jumper no good. Harmon has the basketball taken away by Garrick and gives it now to Kennedy. Yikes.
Yeah.
That could have been easily been the third foul. Camp in the right corner over the defense to Medina. Ball loose, picked up by Medina, gives to Garrick. Alec Garrick from the free throw line, jumper no good, and the ball being tipped around. Kennedy comes out of there with it and is drilled out of bounds by Corey Phillippe. So Luke Kennedy will go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Well, the tone was kind of set that it's okay to be physical. So Southwich came down and played physical D.
Free throw by Kennedy is good. And Coach Burris will go back to the bench and send in Elliott. And he'll replace Hobson, who's been saddled with fouls here in this first half and been very quiet for the Southwood Knights. He comes out. One more coming for Kennedy. Second one on the way for the big man is good, and Rochester within one. 23-22. Southwood to the basketball, 90 seconds to play in the first half. Corey Phillippe crosses the timeline, jump pass in the corner to Elliott, drives the baseline, throws up a shot. It's going to be good and a foul. Alec Garrick picks up foul number three.
Number 24, Alec Garrick in third. Elliott to the line to shoot one. Checking in for the Zebras.
Alec Holland will come back into the game for Rochester and Abbott to make that Garrick to sit down. 1:24 to play in the first half. Southwood now back up by three, and Elliott at the free throw line to shoot one free throw as Screeton comes back into the game for the Rochester Zebras. Free throw is good by Elliott, and that completes a three-point play. The official was going to give him another free throw. The full court press by Southwood, who are now up by 4 points. Screen gets the inbounds pass from Holland. Screen gives the head to Holland now. Alec will cross the timeline. Middle of the floor. No look pass down low. It's kicked away by Southwood, and Rochester will try it again.
Abbott's going to look to key it in for the Zebras. Still looking. Goes long to Holland. Holland working against Phillippe. Loses it and then regains it. As Screeton now with the basketball working against Blair at the top of the key, waiting for a pick from Medina.
Out of the top to Abbott. Abbott on the wing. And that 2-3 zone smothering Screeton.
Yeah.
Jump pass quickly to Holland. Back to Screeton on the right wing. Screeton inside the arc. In the corner to Abbott. 50 seconds to play first half. And Abbott's pass is taken away by Blair. Blair then has it taken away by Holland. Holland will bring it up the floor with 40 seconds of play in the first half. Splits a double team to Kennedy. Luke should have shot that. Now does. Good.
Yeah.
And it's 26-24, 30 seconds of play in the first half. Southwood runs. Blair to Ross Phillippe with 24. Now to Corey Phillippe with 22. He drives it. Jump stop rises up. Good. 28-24, 15 seconds. Medina gets it inbounds at 12. Stolen by Elliott. Gives to Blair. Blair's layup is good. 5 seconds. 4 seconds. Medina ahead to Abbott with three. Abbott with two. Abbott on the baseline, not going to get off a shot. At halftime, Southwood leads 30-24. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle. RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Back at Southwood High School as we go to the third quarter. The Zebras start with the basketball. Going to our left now, Brad Thomas. I'm David Musselman. The Knights lead 30-24. And Kennedy with it. Gives to Streeton, who gives to Garrick. Pull-up jumper over the baseline is no good. And the ball is knocked out of bounds by Garrick, and it'll go back to Southwood going to our right now. North Miami defeated Whitco tonight in varsity guys basketball.
Score of 41-38.
Okay.
Thanks to the all-knowing, ever-present Al Valsasaurus.
That's right. He's everywhere.
Everywhere.
Harmon's leaner off the glass is good. 32-24, and all of a sudden this lead went down to one not very long ago. It's back up to eight. And now the basketball knocked out of bounds by Rochester, and it'll go back to Southwood. 45 seconds gone in the third quarter. And Southwood with an opportunity here to push this one back to double digits. Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Ross Phillippe to Blair. Drives it left. Pull-up jumper over Kennedy. Yep. And now Southwood up by 10 at 34-24. What do you do to Coach Reinhold? You got to stop it right now.
Yeah.
I mean, we're only a minute in, but you still got to stop it. Holland. Bounce line, baseline pass to Medina. Out to Garrick, left side to Holland, fakes the three, steps back, fires a three, it's no good. Ball fought for, Harmon comes out of there with it, and now gives to Corey Phillippe. Southwood runs up by 10. Corey Phillippe fills the middle of the floor, now works to the right elbow. Left side to Blair. Blair dumps down low to Harmon, left block, jumper over Kennedy, Gip.
That's three, automatic.
And now Southwood is up by 12, biggest lead of the night at 36-24. Full court press by Southwood. Holland at the elbow to Kennedy on the outside left. Cross court right to Streeton. Streeton against Corey Phillippe. Feeds down a little Medina against Harmon. Jumper on the way in the paint. No good. Kennedy with the rebound. His put back on the way is no good, but a foul coming on Harmon. That's going to send Kennedy to the line to shoot two.
Harmon's going to pick up his second.
Number 24, Alex Harmon. His second.
6 minutes to play in the third. Southwood by 12.
I know Kennedy got the rebound and the foul and is going to go to the free throw line and get the points, but I thought Medina really set that up. He called for the ball down low. Holland was able to get it to him as Kennedy knocks the first one down.
And he posted up.
And he made a good, strong move to the basket, you know, against a much taller player in Harmon.
I'm not sure we've seen that yet tonight, that strong a move in the post for Rochester. Kennedy looking for one more, looking to push his numbers to 10. He does so. He's got 10 of the night, and it cuts the Southwood lead to 10. Again, with 6 minutes to play in the third quarter, Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Ross Phillippe gives to Blair. Left side of the floor, works away from the double team. High on the left side, still swings right side. Corey Phillippe drives the baseline. Back outside left wing to Blair. Looks at a three, passes it up. Couple of dribbles, now out to Ross Phillippe, to Corey Phillippe. Drives the baseline, jump stop, tipped away and stolen by Alec Garrick. Ahead to Alec Holland. Holland outside to Garrick, fakes the three, drives it in the paint, rises up over Harmon, no good. Harmon gets the board and clears to Ross Phillippe. Southwood runs up by 10, 5.5 to play in the third. Ross Phillippe, no look pass to Blair. He'll fire a three in Medina's face. It's good as it rolls around three times and goes in.
The Blair Harmon show here in the third quarter for Southwood.
39-26, Southwood up by 13. Holland, middle of the floor, out to Streeton, back to Holland, high on the right side. Southwood still in that 2-3 zone, and Ross Phillippe forces a turnover as he bangs it off the foot of Holland and out of bounds. 5:07 to play in the third. There's one of the things that could have been a reach-in foul, but wasn't called.
You're right.
Oh, my. Elliott saves it right into the hands of Harmon, and he misses the 5-foot bunny, and Kennedy with a rebound. Streeton against the double team, high over the top of the defense to Kennedy, drives it left in the paint, goes to the basket, foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two, and a foul coming on the Southwood Knights. And so Kennedy looking to pad his stats here.
So that foul coming against Corey Phillippe, his second.
Kennedy at the line to shoot two. 4:47 to play in the third quarter. It's a 13-point lead right now for Southwood. Kennedy eyes it, flies it, yep. Abbott and Camp back into the game. Garrick and Streeton to sit. Also Hobson back in for Southwood, and Elliott checks out.
Well, it's a testament to that Southwood defense. These are the easiest shots Rochester's had all night.
Yeah.
On the free throw line.
It has been in your face the entire night. So Luke Kennedy cuts the lead to 11 with two freebies. Blair works it across the timeline, now in the left corner against a double team. Got to get rid of it. Does so over the top, and he's going to throw it out of bounds. And it's going to go back to Rochester. Nice job by the Zebras to force that turnover, and Rochester going to get it back. Down by 11. Holland will look to trigger it in. Gets it into Medina. Medina fakes the pass, drives it left, cut off, gives to Holland. Fakes a three just inside the three-point line. Back to Medina now. Baseline to Abbott. Brett in the paint against the triple team. Out to Kennedy. Three on the way, top of the key. Good! And it's 39-31.
17 now for Kennedy.
Rochester just won't go away. Blair over the top of the defense, and it's tipped out of bounds by Kennedy. Boy, Luke is having a game. He is all over the place. Tough to throw it over someone as long as Luke is.
You're right.
4 minutes to play in the third. Southwood lead down to 8. Corey Phillippe gives to Ross Phillippe. Works the middle of the floor against Rochester's 2-3 zone. Works it to the left side. Now Hobson high on the left side to Phillippe. Corey, that is, on the baseline. Top of the key to Ross Phillippe. Drives it to the elbow. Backs his way in. Now pulls it back outside. Now works the left side. Switches directions. Gives to Harmon to the right elbow. Outside to Ross Phillippe, who drives it right to Blair. He'll fire a three. It's short. Rebound tipped around. Ross Phillippe has it. He'll put it up. Blocked. Harmon to the rebound for Southwood. Ball being fought for. Medina comes out of there with it. You should have known he would win that.
All you saw was a hand go up amongst the crowd and grab that ball and whip it down. No idea who it was.
Kennedy then throws the ball away to Ross Phillippe, who gives to Hobson, and Southwood runs up by 8. Hobson, middle of the floor. Right side to Ross Phillippe. Down low to wide open Blair. His jumper good, and a foul.
Well, it's been all Blair and Alex Harmon here in the third quarter for Southwood. Those two have combined for 11 points here in this quarter.
So the lead is back to 10 for Southwood. Nope, the lead is back to 9. And now 10 with Blair hitting the free throw with 3:16 to play. In the third quarter, Southwood back up. I don't think that's right. I think it should be 41-31. Camp gets it across to Holland. Holland almost loses his footing. He gets a double team, gets to Medina. Medina on the baseline, throws it in the backcourt, and it'll be a turnover, Rochester. Now Rochester will take a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I'll keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
2:57 to play in the third quarter. Southwood back out in front by 11 points at 42-31. And after the timeout, Southwood will have it going to our right. Boy, you just keep chipping and chipping and chipping and chipping, and you get it down to manageable distance between you and your opponent, and then a couple of buckets, a couple of turnovers, and bam, it's back to 11-point deficit.
Yeah, turnovers will kill you in a hurry, especially if they can convert those turnovers quickly into points.
And Southwood has.
And that's what you're exactly right. Yep. That's what they've done tonight.
Corey Phillippe against a triple team, loses the basketball, ball loose on the floor. Kennedy picks it up, and Lou gives off to Holly. Holland against Dobson, to Medina, across to Holland. Holland high on the right side, dribbles away from trouble, gives to Kennedy at the free throw line. Ball tipped around, Southwood steals it. Corey to Ross, no look pass to Harmon. His jumper no good, but a foul coming on Southwood. I think Ross Phillippe wanted to see Harmon dunk again.
Yep. A lot of defenders in the way, though.
And Rochester going to be whistled for a foul.
That's Holland's third.
So Alex Harmon at the line to shoot two shots for Southwood, looking to push this lead back to 13. It's where it once was in this quarter. Lefty fires the first one, no good. Alec Garrick back into the game. Brett Abbott will sit. Harmon with one more free throw, looking to push his Southwood Knights back to a 12-point lead. Harmon, short, just barely drew iron, and Kennedy with a rebound. That's one of those self-defense rebounds because it came off the rim so fast.
You're right. Get your hands up, save your nose.
And Alec Holland's foul going to the baseline by Corey Phillippe. And I believe that'll be number three on Phillippe.
Yes, it is. And he has not scored since about midway through that second quarter.
Screen back into the game, Camp to come out. 2:19 to play in the third, Southwood by 12. Medina will trigger it in right in front of his own bench. Medina over the top of the defense. Kennedy, his three is off the back of the rim, no good. Harmon skies to the board and gives to Corey Phillippe. Southwood runs. Corey Phillippe gives to Ross Phillippe, top of the key. 2-3 zone by the Zebra defense. High on the left side to Blair, now in the corner to Hobson. Hobson a couple of dribbles back to Blair, swings the near side to Ross Phillippe. To Blair, another three on the way. Good again.
Wow. That's 11 points in this quarter alone for Blair, 18 in the game.
And now it's a 14-point lead for Southwood at 45-31 with 100 seconds to play in the third quarter. The ball is knocked out of bounds by Southwood. It will stay right in front of standing on the baseline against the Rochester. Screeton will look to trigger it in. Screeton studies, bounce pass into Kennedy. Luke, cross-court pass to Holland, three on the way, right baseline, no good. Kennedy's putback is good. 45-33, Southwood by 12. A minute 25 to play in the third quarter. Bounce pass ahead to Harmon, who loses it out of bounds. Boy, I'll give the officials credit. They let him play in the first half, and they're continuing to let him play here in the second.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to let both teams be aggressive.
So Rochester gets it back down by 12. Minute 15 to play in the third quarter. Screen gets it across the timeline from Holland. And then his pass is kicked away by Hobson and out of bounds. Don't forget, Brad.
Okay.
The telephone auction starts tomorrow morning. All right. 9:30 on WROI.
I'll put that in my phone.
Have you gotten Lisa a Valentine's Day present?
I'm not familiar. I'm not familiar with that.
I kind of figured.
With that.
Kennedy drives, kicks it out to Street, and three on the way, right side. Good! And the lead back down to 9.
What is this Valentine's Day you speak of?
Yeah, it's a new thing.
Okay.
Don't worry about it.
All right.
Yeah. Hobson, low look pass to Corey Phillippe. Backs his way inside the three-point line. Jump pass to Ross Phillippe. Back to Hobson on the right side. Baseline to Corey Phillippe. Corey Phillippe, a couple of dribbles against the double team. Sends left wing. Is tipped away by Holland. Gives to Medina. Medina goes to the basket. Goes up for the shot. Good and a foul.
Nice job by Medina to recognize that he had company coming down the floor with him. You give him a little pump fake and drew the foul.
Number 34, Ross Phillippe.
So to finish that thought, that's a 9:30 start tomorrow morning.
On the telephone auction.
That's on the telephone auction. Some pretty cool stuff. I looked at the board today.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty cool.
All right.
It's a secret.
There you go.
Yeah. Medina looks at finish the three-point play, and he cannot. He misses the free throw. 35 seconds to play in the third quarter. 45-38, Southwood. Blair out to Ross Phillippe with 29 against the 2-3 zone to Hobson. To Elliott, outside to Blair with 20. Leaner is short. Kennedy with the board with 18. Now to Screeton with 16. He pushes it up the floor with 15. He almost loses the handle, and the ball is knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Hobson. And boy, Hobson, lucky he didn't pick up foul number four there.
You're right. Coach Reinholt was begging for one, and it didn't happen.
Coach Burris didn't like the call. Coach Reinholt didn't like the no call. Why would you ever want to be an official? Camp.
You notice none of them have any hair.
With seven now to Streeton. He holds with six. Drives it left with four. Streeton picks up the basketball with three. Gives out to Kennedy with two. Jumper the buzzer is high off the rim. No good. After three, Southwood leads 45-38. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Fourth and final quarter we go at Southwood High School, where the Southwood Knights now lead only by 7 at 45-38. And, you know, we've seen it the entire game. Southwood gets out to double digits, and Rochester keeps fighting back and fighting back. They would use a little of that energy. Right now only down by 7. Maybe they get it to 5. Maybe they get it to 4.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, they just need to keep fighting. A little more defensive effort, a little more, you know, get a rebound, hold Southwood to one effort, one shot and done. And, you know, but I think, you know, they're definitely doing what they need to do to try and stay in it.
I agree. Southwood starts the fourth quarter of the basketball as Blair with the basketball. High on the left side to Ross Phillippe. Back to Blair, high on the right side. You watching the Olympics?
Not at the moment.
Nor am I. Hobson pulls up from 15 feet. It's off the mark, no good, but a rebound offensively to Blair, who loses it to Camp. 2-1 break for Rochester. Camp to the basket. Throws up a shot, blocked out of bounds.
I hear they started this week.
So. Yesterday.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure how you start and then have opening ceremonies tonight.
They do that every year, though.
They do?
Yeah, they always – well, not every year. They don't have the Olympics every year, but they do it every time the Olympics are around. They do have, all the preliminary stuff ahead of time.
I see. A high three by Cramp goes, and it's good. That thing bounced off the rafters three times and falls through, and the Southwood lead is down to 4. Good heavens, that was up there. That would have literally bounced off the ceiling at Rochester. And then Luke Kennedy picks up a foul on the baseline. It'll be out of bounds to Southwood.
So 4-point game.
Yeah.
more shots like that.
The hang time on that was about 5.3.
That's the kind of thing you do for horse.
That's what Larry Bird did, wasn't it?
For a happy
and
for a Big Mac.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. That's exactly right. Double team. Hobson gives out to Blair. Blair just inside the arc, left-handed shot. It's good. That's a big-time shot from 18 feet away.
Well, I tell you what, Blair's got 20 right now with that shot, and he and Harmon are the only two players that have scored since halftime for Southwood.
They single-handedly stretch this game to 13-15
yeah.
in the third quarter. Cam gravels. So the lead is six for Southwood. 6:46 to play
yep.
in the basketball game.
They each have timeouts left. How's that?
Don't call him the best color man in the league for nothing, folks.
You're right.
Hobson across the timeline against Rochester's 2-3 zone. Ross Phillippe gives to Blair. Jump pass back outside to Ross Phillippe high on the left side. Back to Blair on the left wing. Blair right side to a cutting Hobson. Layup is good.
That's his first bucket of the night.
And the lead is back to 8 in favor of Southwood. And then Corey Phillippe steals the basketball and then dribbles it out of bounds. John Burris looked at it. He knew it was out of bounds, and it looked at the official like, you got to be kidding me, that was out of bounds?
Yeah. He wouldn't be doing his job if he didn't
yeah.
question at all.
That's right. 6:21 to play in the game, 49-41. Southwood on top. Zebras of the basketball going to our left. Holland gets the pass from Screeton, who crosses the timeline now, right and wing. Looking to dribble away from trouble, gives to Screeton now. Down low to Garrick, wide open. Layup is good. Beautiful. 49-43 Southwood. 2 minutes gone in the final quarter. Harmon back into the game at the next opportunity. Corey Phillippe out to Dobson, or Hobson that is. Now to Ross Phillippe, to Corey Phillippe, outside to Blair, three left wing. Nope. Rebound to Streeton. Southwood by six. Rochester the basketball with 5:45 to play in the game. Now a loose ball on the floor. Ball still loose. Garrett gives to Streeton, and we're going to have a timeout by Rochester. Rochester will take a 30. It's a Zebra. No, it'll be a 60. I beg your pardon, Don. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community. Family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
5 minutes, 39 seconds to play in the fourth quarter. The Southwood Knights lead the Rochester Zebras 49-43. Rochester has two timeouts left. Southwood has four. And this is a, well, I'm not sure if I can say this is a big possession, because I think every possession from here on out is a big possession when you're down by six.
You're right, it is. You know, when you're the team that's behind in the last 5.5 minutes of a game, you're right, every possession is a big one.
Folks, you're missing it. If you're not here watching this fight, then
yeah.
I am truly impressed with this team effort tonight. They have fought the entire game. They've gotten down, they fought their way back. They've gotten down, they fought their way back. And it just depends how much fight they've got left in them. Garrick. Has his pass, nope, not tipped out of bounds, just goes out of bounds. Going to go back to Southwood. I thought maybe Corey Phillippe got a finger on that.
Those are the kind of things that are, you know, you just can't afford to do. You can't waste a possession like that.
So Blair will bring it up the floor against the half-court trap, and now we're going to have a reach-in on Streeton. Wow,
that was quick. That's Streeton's third.
And Camp will quickly come into the game. And Camp will replace Streeton with three personals. 5:21 to play in the ball game. Southwood by six. Both teams with four team fouls, so we're a ways away yet from shooting.
That might be something Rochester may want to start taking into consideration.
Could be. You're right. Ross Phillippe against a double team. Middle, dribbles in the middle of the floor. Gets it out to Blair. Blair being attacked by a triple team. And then has his pass stolen by Camp, who cannot save him from going out of bounds. Man, I tell you what, this is probably the best defensive game I've seen for Rochester.
Yeah, we got bodies on the floor and people diving for loose balls.
You hear the expression, leave everything out on the floor. We're seeing that tonight. Blair, right side to Hobson, high on the right side, over the top of the defense to Ross Phillippe picks up his dribble, gives to Hobson right wing, back to Phillippe, middle of the floor. Ross Phillippe holds over the top of the defense to Blair. Back to Ross Phillippe in the center circle. Drives it right. Back to Blair. Blair just inside the arc, off the glass. His jumper no good. The offensive rebound by Ross Phillippe is partially blocked. Medina picks it up, gives it ahead to Holland. Holland goes to the basket. Layup is on the way. It's blocked by Blair. And Blair picks it up and runs.
Both coaches now up and yelling for
begging for a call. You're right.
Contact, yeah.
Ross Phillippe near side to Hobson, who gives to Blair. Blair, who's had a fantastic second half and a fantastic game for Southwood. Now to Hobson high on the right side, over the top of the defense. To Ross Phillippe in the center circle, now left side to Blair. Blair over the head pass to Ross Phillippe. To Corey Phillippe in the paint. Jumps down low. He's going to be fouled on the shot by Kennedy. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Kennedy picks up his first.
4:11 to play in the game. Rochester trails the Southwood Knights 49-43. And Corey Phillippe at the line to shoot. Two shots for the Southwood Knights.
He's got 9 points for Southwood. Has not scored since the second quarter.
Has an opportunity to push this lead to 8. First one's good. It's 50-43. One more coming for Phillippe. The Rochester Lady Zebras back in action tomorrow night as they close out the regular season at home with the Manchester Lady Squires. 6:15, I believe, 6:15 tip for JV, about 7:30-ish or so start time for varsity as Phillippe misses the free throw. Kennedy has it. He drives it. Kennedy then is going to be fouled on the reach-in from behind by Hobson, and it'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 4 to play in the game.
Hobson picks up his third. So who's your favorite curling team?
Well, the U.S.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I enjoy curling.
Do you?
I do.
Yeah. It's not that I don't like the U.S., but I kind of think Canada's the favorite.
Well, I'm sure you're right.
Didn't
so says the guy who never watches curling.
I don't know. Didn't they invent it?
I'm sure they did.
What else is there to do in Canada?
Medina grabs the offensive board and puts it back and good. 50-45. Hobson quickly up the floor. Switches directions. His pass is partially tipped. Corey Phillippe has it. Then he is fouled from behind by Camp. And is that going to be 7 on the Zebras? Yep, they'll go to the Southwood. Will shoot free throws here from here on out. 3:41 to play in the game. Southwood by 5.
Camp picks up his second.
Yeah, now it's 6. So they will not be shooting free throws. It'll be out of bounds to Southwood. Three 3:41 to play in the game. Southwood by 5, out of bounds to the Knights, baseline right. Corey Phillippe will look to get it in. Phillippe over the top of the defense to Ross Phillippe near the timeline. Ross holds. Camp comes out to apply pressure. Left wing pass to Hobson. Back to Phillippe now in the center circle. Back to Hobson high on the left side. Back to Phillippe in the center circle. Right side now to Blair. Blair cross-court pass to Hobson. Back to Phillippe in the center circle. Ross Phillippe around the defense. Couple of dribbles to Hobson. Back to Phillippe, middle of the floor. Hobson high on the left side to Phillippe near the timeline. 3:15 to play in the game. Southwood by 5. Phillippe holds in the center circle. To Corey Phillippe at the free throw line. Out to Hobson. Looks at a 3. Passes it up. Ross Phillippe top of the key. Ross Phillippe at the 10-second line. Baseball pass to Blair. Back to Phillippe. And he holds in the center circle. At the free throw line to Corey Phillippe. Jumper short. Kennedy with the board. Man, they were doing so well.
I know, yeah. Yep. It's hard to hold that ball for 2 minutes when you run a score. You want to score.
Rochester down by 5. 2:40 to play in the game. Camp for 3, left baseline is no good, and the rebound is tipped around, saved from going out of bounds by Blair, and it'll be Rochester basketball. As Blair could not save from going out of bounds, Street will come into the game. Boy, Camp had a great look from this corner again, couldn't get it to go.
Nobody came out to get on him.
2:35 to play in the game, Southwood up by 5. The lob pass into Kennedy, his shot's good, and a foul!
Nice job by Luke Kennedy.
The lob pass comes into Kennedy while he's in air grabbing the ball. He puts it off the glass and 2, and he is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot 1.
And Harmon picks up his 3rd.
And Kennedy can cut this to a 2-point lead.
And it moves both teams to that 6th foul. So they'll be shooting on the next one.
Luke Kennedy looking for his 20th point, and he gets it on the free throw. 50-48 Southwood, 2.5 to play in the game. Blair around the defense to Ross Phillippe, to Corey Phillippe, to Hobson. 15-footer right baseline's no good. Harmon's putback is good as it comes over the back of Holland, and no call.
Yeah, Holland was trying everything he could to block him out, but that height differential is just too much.
Straighten over the top of the defense to Kennedy. Luke in the paint. Kicks it outside to Holland. 3 left baseline is short, and the ball is going to be tipped out of bounds, and we're going to have a foul of Adina, as he, I believe, was working against Harmon down low, and that's going to send Blair to the free throw line for one of the bonus.
It'll be Medina's third.
2:05 to play in the game. 52-48 Southwood.
Well, Southwood just 6 of 11 from the free throw line tonight, so these aren't automatic.
You're right. Blair, left-handed free throw is no good. Good call, Brad. And Kennedy with the board. Screen has a pass taken away by Corey Phillippe. And now gives to Blair, to Hobson. And his pass is taken away by Gehrig. Gehrig runs, 1:50 to play in the game. And he loses the basketball. Out of bounds, last touch by Southwood. It'll stay with Rochester. 1:47 to play in the game. 52-48 Southwood.
What did John Wooden say? Be quick, but don't hurry. And
yep.
These guys need to take note of that.
That's exactly right. Medina gets it into Screeton. Passes up at 3 and drives. Outside to Kennedy. Luke with 20 points tonight. One dribble to Screeton with 1:38 to play in the game. Rochester down by 4. Screeton high on the right side over the top of the defense to Gehrig. In the corner to Holland. Down low to Kennedy. Luke against Harmon. Kicks it out to Gehrig. 3 right wing. Short. And the rebound is tipped out of bounds by Rochester. And Southwood going to get it back with 1:22 to play in the game. Up by 4.
Gehrig coming in trying to make a play on the missed shot. Knocked it out of bounds.
Hobson will bring it up for Rochester, or make that Southwood. And how soon now will Rochester start the foul? Blair against a double team. Over the top to Corey Phillippe. Now to Hobson. A couple of dribbles to Harmon in the right corner. Top of the key down to Ross Phillippe with 1 minute to play in the game.
Well,
Southwood by 4.
And about anybody's fair game except for Corey Phillippe. Or fouling them when they're doing a layup.
Harmon just got fouled and hacked in the act, and he'll go to the line to shoot 1. Looking to push this lead back to 7.
So Harmon now with 14, and while he is 0 for 4 from the free throw line tonight, he still had to give up that basket.
Rochester will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
.3 to play in the game. The Southwood Knights up 54-48, and after the Rochester timeout, Alex Harmon at the line to shoot 1 free throw, looking to complete the 3-point play. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We've seen a pretty good game.
Yeah, we have. Every time Rochester pushes, gets the lead down to 2, Southwood expands it back to 6.
Harmon misses a free throw. Streeton has it. They head to Holland. 3 on the way, right side. No good. And the rebound to Ross Phillippe. Phillippe against the triple team. Uses a timeout. Southwood will take a timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
.4 seconds to play in the game. Southwood owns a 6-point lead at 54-48. Both teams in the bonus. Southwood will inbound right in front of the Rochester bench. Hobson looking to get it in. Does so to Ross Phillippe. Ross Phillippe running the point most of the night tonight. Crosses the timeline. Gives to Hobson. Has it knocked out of bounds by Kennedy. And Kennedy and Streeton run into each other. And Streeton gives him a shoulder right in the jaw. 38.5 to play in the game. Hobson again will look to get it in. Bounce pass is kicked away. And we'll do it again. One timeout left for Rochester. Southwood with three. And the pass comes into Blair, who's fouled hard by Gehrig. And Jackson Blair will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Gehrig picks up his fourth.
37 seconds to play in the game. Southwood by six. So coming back into the game is Camp. And Medina to sit. Nope. Yep, Medina will come out.
So the senior Jackson Blair with 20 points tonight for Southwood. One of two from the line.
Southwood has three in double figures. Free throw no good. Kennedy the rebound. Street and run. Holland three over Phillippe. It's
wow.
Good! Timeout Rochester! 54-51, Southwood. It's a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I'll keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
30.5 seconds to play in the game. Southwood up by three at 54-51. Rochester being a full-court press. Southwood needs to go the length of the floor. Southwood now in the double bonus. Hobson looks to get it in around Holland. Hobson gets it into Ross Phillippe. Ross Phillippe with the basketball. Hold both travels. Gives off to Blair, who crosses the timeline left. Blair, is fouled. That whistle was blown before the contact was made. So Blair will go to the line to shoot two free throws. And I think you nailed it earlier, Brad, when you said it doesn't matter who you foul this at this point. Nobody can hit a free throw.
Right, anybody except Corey Phillippe. He's the only one that's made any free throws tonight. Well, Blair's made one.
And he missed that one bad. He'll have one more.
Missed his last three.
54-51 Southwood. 22.5 seconds to play in the game. Blair with one more freebie for the night. Sets himself. Second one is no good. Kennedy with a rebound. Gives to Streeton. We're down to 18. Streeton across the timeline with 16. Streeton works to the right side with 14. Streeton directs traffic with 12. Streeton holds with 10. Streeton high on the right side with 9. Gehrig with 7. Gehrig with 6. Out to Kennedy. Outside to Holland with 3. Camp jumper with 1. No good. That'll do it. Southwood holds on to beat the Rochester Zebras 54-51. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.